Hi, I'm Some Tech Guy and welcome back. Today, we're going to change the fans on an Asus TUF 3070 Ti, but it's the same for the entire TUF range. We will go through the process step by step so you know exactly what to expect and give you some important tips for buying those replacement fans, so stick around for those. The job is straightforward and it only uses a single screwdriver and doesn't require you to remove the heatsink or the backplate and doesn't need you to damage the warranty seal if you have one. We will first of all remove the screws needed to remove the fan shroud. This will enable us to get to the cables and remove the fans. We will then need to unscrew any fans we are replacing from the heatsink. These are mounted with four screws as you can see here. Three around the fan, with one at the PCIe slot side of the card that holds the fan cables in place. Let's go ahead and remove the fan shroud screws, put these somewhere safe. You can see here that the fan header connection is awkwardly connected at the end of the PCB between the backplate and the heatsink. Now, let's remove the fan shroud and fold it up and away from the heatsink. It's connected with a cable at the top of the card to join the small RGB to a connector just next to the fan header. You don't need to remove this, just keep the shroud next to the card like you see here. Here you can see where the fan header is connected. The connector has a key tab that you need to press to release the cable and it is difficult to get to. The cable then runs up to three fans which are individually cabled and can be unplugged if you wish to replace any single fan. The plugs are tight and you need a strong wiggle side to side to release them from each other. Here are my replacement fans and for this walkthrough I am going to replace all three. Now let's remove the existing fans. I remove the three screws with the cable retainers at the bottom of the card first and then, moving left to right, remove the further three screws from each fan. You will see that there are two pieces of tape that hold the fan connectors in place in the cable channel. These pieces of tape ensure the cables stay in place and don't move around, potentially contacting the fans. Don't remove the tape entirely, you want to stick it back down to hold the new cables in place. It's actually better to peel the tape from the side opposite the fan if possible, and this means the unstuck side doesn't get loose and touch on the fan edge. This cable is the fan header connector. It can be awkward to work with, but press the tab here like I'm showing and then wiggle the connector off. It may help to reach through the gap in the back plate if it's awkward to get in through the side. Here you can see a close-up of the back of the fan. All three will have the same model number, which I'm pointing to. These are the fans that you will want to buy as replacements, and you can get these from sites like eBay. I'm going to give you some specific pointers a little later so you don't have any issues with this process. My replacements have the same model numbers, though you may see there are some very slight variations in the fan label. You will see that my replacements do fit and they work perfectly. Now let's fit the new fans, and there is something very important to consider during this process. I will screw in the first retaining screw, which holds the cable near the cable channel. You will need to ensure that the cable is flat and secured underneath the plastic clip, like you see here. If the cable isn't secured under here, it will likely catch on the fan blades, which could stop them spinning or potentially damage them. Once the first fan is in, let's go ahead and position the cables and screw down just that screw in each of the fans to ensure the fan and the cabling is in place. Next, we need to ensure that the cables are all sitting well in the cable channel. This ensures the shroud will sit correctly, but also that the cables won't come in contact with the fans themselves because the TUF card is fairly compact and the cables do sit quite close to the fan edges. Stick the tape down to hold the cables in place, ready for the shroud to be installed. Now, let's screw the rest of the fan retainer screws and I will give you some important tips for finding your fans. Starting with tip 1, check the model numbers for your fans so you can find the correct replacements. I will put the model numbers from mine that you saw in this video down below in the comments. Tip 2, check the dimensions of your existing fans to ensure that any fans you order match. It isn't just the diameter but also the depth of the fans and the dimensions of the screw holes on the mounting. I will also place the dimensions of the fans I removed in the comments below for reference. Tip 3, check the cable lengths and that the cables have the correct plugs. Each fan has a different plug on it with a different pin count, so make sure you get the correct parts to replace your fan or check you're getting the 3 correct units if you're replacing all 3. The model numbers on the fan are the same for all 3 units and don't have a bearing on the cable pinouts. Tip 4, look carefully at the pictures of the fans you are buying and ensure their quality looks good and that they are direct replacements. Buying cheaper options is not always the best option. Right, now check the fans rotate and that there's no sign or sound indicating that anything is rubbing or fouling on the fan shroud. Now we can screw the fan shroud screws in and secure the shroud back onto the heatsink. This is just the 6 screws on the edges of the card. And now let's reconnect the fans to the header socket. This is the fiddliest part of the TUF fan replacement due to the location of the header socket on the end of the PCB, where it is in between the backplate and the heatsink. If you have larger hands, this can be quite awkward and you may need to experiment with either the side of the card or reaching through the hole in the backplate. The objective here is to get the cable correctly lined up and then it's fairly easy to push it in until you hear a click. And you can see that the retaining tab has dropped into place. Finally, the connector is seated properly and we can now test the card. And as always, a big thank you for watching and I hope this helps you get your Asus TUF Gaming GPU fixed with minimum fuss and cost. If this was useful, I would really appreciate a like or please do subscribe for more videos like these ones. And as always, see you in the next.